أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، والصلاة والسلام على أشرف المرسلين سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه وأنصاره أجمعين. My dear brothers and sisters, quick one. The Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام said: لا يدخل الجنة من كان في قلبه مثقال ذرة من كبر. No one will go to paradise if he had an atom of pride. Another narration, حبة خردل, the weight of a mustard seed of كبر. And the Sahaba straight away asked the Prophet ﷺ, said, Oh Prophet, people want, they love to have a nice gown or nice shoes. And he said, this is not the كبر. الكبر بطر الحق وغمط الناس. بطر الحق وغمط الناس. It's very difficult to translate these two words, بطر وغمط. But the closest I can find, disclaiming truth out of self-esteem and despising people. When I see this hadith, straight away click to my mind this khanzir, the Zimbali, and shows you how these people are wicked. A little piece of dirt call himself instructor, and then he call himself ustaz, teacher. And wallahi, someone send me link, he's sheikh now. And this Ibn al-Khanzira, because she didn't teach him, I told him, tell me if she teach you or no. He said, where is the scholar? Where is the scholar? Khanzir coming, economic refugee coming from nowhere. Like, and this is what we're going to talk about, how they brought these people to use them as to fight Islam. You get some people from different country of the world, never seen any grace, come here, they become slaves, they become dogs. You give them hungry, you give him meat, and he always come for the meat. This piece of they say, where the shuyukh, where's the ulama? So straight away, some people tell me why you insult him. I insult him because the Prophet said, Al-ulama warth al-anbiya. Scholar are the inheritors of the prophets. When piece of dirt like this had constipated face, you see his face, but Allah, you can tell someone have ejaculation in his brain. What is this? Where is the scholar? You never seen because you eat haram. When you eat haram, your eyes is useless. Your ears is useless. Your everything is useless. Only you see yourself, a little piece of that. Where the scholar? Sheikh Sulaiman Alwan, not muhaddith. May Allah release him. Abdul Aziz Tarifi, not muhaddith. AAA, may Allah bless him. AMG, may Allah bless him and protect him. Sheikh Abdullah Azam, ya Khanzir, there is some shuyukh, your master paid million and million to get rid of them. Why? Because they love Islam? No. Because they know these people are the reformists, people who are going to wake up the nation. Another hadith, the Prophet ﷺ said, سَنَوَاتٌ خَدَّعَاتٌ, a deceiving years. Years of deception. A liar will be believed. A liar like Sharmusa, Ibn Safi, Ibn Najas, when he used to say, I'm spy, I am terrorist, I am Dawla, اي ام ثاني تراب، اي ام روافد، اي ام خارجي. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give me 100 shaitan and tell me Omar, this devil gonna help you to find a way to expose Shamsi. They will never do. Shamsi ibn al-Najas now exposed internationally by the blessing of Allah, not me. And I asked the brother who speak Arabic, listen to Tamir al-Labban. Tamir al-Labban or Muhammad Samir. Those people are learned about Islam and they can give you evidence. And I ask the brother, whoever speak Arabic and English, please brother translate small. This some video 2 minutes, 3 minutes, because this filth will gonna come recycle again. Sharmusa ibn al-Najas, he didn't say sorry, I'm sorry. He didn't say, he's still saying MBS Salafi and this Salafi. And I like a video, may Allah bless him, the brother who put it on. Sheikh AMG said, yes, they are Salaf, Amr ibn Luhay. The Salaf is the one who introduced worshipping statues and slaughter for the statue. I ask your brother to be very, very aware from this khanzir, this dayus, this little dry, it's not dry yet. The Prophet said in the hadith, a liar will be trusted, and the trusted man will be disbelieved, and the traitor will be trusted and believed, and the trustworthy not gonna be believed. ويتكلم الرويبدة. I find the الرويبدة trivial man, little piece of dirt. عبد الرحمن عبدي الرحمن حسن يتكلم في أمور العامة. Yeah, the youth, Islam is not Tesco or Asda. You pick up what you want. No, ya khanzir. Now you do in the same thing as the son of pigs done before you. You pick up and choose. In Islam, you take it all or you leave it all. But your masters, when you came hungry like a dog, they use you. They make problem in Somalia. A lot of people come here. First dog come, give him some meat, and they use him. They make problem in Algeria. A lot of dogs come here. The first one give him meat, become Shamsi. From Somalia become Zumbali, become Abdurrahman Khassan. And on, from Jordan, Sheikh Donkey, and go on. They use you. Dogs give you some meat, recycled meat, and you think you are this. And when you go holiday, you go to the second-hand shop, you buy some milk, Armani or Sistani or whatever, and Louis Vigo, and you go there, oh, Britain is beautiful, Britain this, and you sold your deen. فيا بائع الغالي ببخس معجل كأنك لا تدري ولا أنت تعلم. Oh, you fool, you're selling something precious with no price. You're selling your God, you're selling Allah. You're selling Muhammad as salam. You're selling the Quran. You're selling وَلِمَنْ خَافَ مَقَامَ رَبِّهِ جَنَّتَانِ. You're selling the Jannah. Even the Muslim life is Jannah. Before you go to Jannah, he enjoy, everything beautiful for him. One Ibn Dayutha, like you, told me, don't you see your life? You live in a hell. Wallahi al-Azim, I live in the top of the hell. Hell, H-I-L-L. Because I see the dogs. When you work for Allah, you can see the dogs going. Keep licking. And inshallah, we follow. Assalamu alaikum.